All right, this is not a drill. My favorite movie of all time is The Lion King. Where did stock up for you?
It's up there, not in the low one.
Yeah, so it premiered Wednesday. Today is Sunday. They had a special premiere. I don't know. Screening. You have the ticket? Alright, come roar with us. That's so sad. But got the tickets, and first time I've ever seen a screen at 10:30 a.m. And now we're gonna eat, because we haven't eaten. What time is it now? It's now 10:24. We've been up since 6, and we haven't eaten yet. So, fill the bellies, get to the movie, and we'll let you know how it goes after. My baby, you ever got the high grade? Spliffing her mouth, eat up the chalice and say, shall we please? Alright, we just pulled up, and there are about 5,000 kids here. I think it's like us. We're the only unaccompanied adults here. Ask me if I care. You care? I don't care. So there was a huge line around the front. So we came around the back, and it's empty. I don't know why people would be lining up around the front if they don't need to be. But you know, I ain't mad. Oh, in there it is. Wow.
You guys want
to go in and hold seats, I guess? Yeah. Okay. It's not 3D. Oh, yes. It's 3D. Shit. Oh, it's hot. Alright. Walking out. Got it. It was good. I think we spoiled, because we had the original. And I've seen it like 5,000 times. So I have that benchmark to go off of. So it was good. But I feel like it would be better if I hadn't seen the first one.
Why the hell did I dress up?
No. Definitely teared up at that very last part. Not gonna lie. But more on that later. Alright guys, we are back at home. It's nighttime. You know, we could have done this earlier, but some people wanted to sleep for the rest of the day. Anyway, I thought we should give our thoughts on the movie, what we thought about it. Now, I've said it before, I'll say it again. The original Lion King is my favorite movie ever. I've seen that movie probably 100 times, and so there was a lot of expectations going into it when I went to see it, and I think she feels similar. What the hell are you doing?
Smile.
I mean, you have to hold it. Relax. God. Alright, so now that the braces are hidden,
yeah.
You know, so I know I had a lot of expectations of the movie. I believe Gilly really liked it, really loved the original, and so it would probably be the same for her. I won't speak for her. Maybe, hey guys, maybe we'll actually get one or two words out of her today.
Well, yeah, I love The Lion King. It's my favorite Disney movie, animation, whatever you call that. But yeah, so I was going into it really excited, and yeah, but I liked it.
So first off, let's start off by saying we both really like the movie. I won't say I loved it yet. I'm gonna watch it a couple more times, a few more times. I will say that it's beautiful. It's one of the most beautiful movies I've ever seen, just because of the technology that was in it. Nothing is real, right? At least in Jungle Book, Mowgli was real. Nothing is real in this movie.
Yeah.
And you have to keep telling yourself that, or else really and truly, all I was missing from a visual standpoint is what's his name? David Attenborough. That's all I was missing. His voice is all I was missing from that movie, because it was pretty much like we were watching National Geographic or Planet Earth or whatever you want called one of those documentaries. So it's definitely worth watching for that. In terms of
And it is a Lion King. There's nothing nothing different to the movie.
Yeah, they did it like
from 94. And you know, a couple of new stuff. There's a new Beyonce song in there which I could have done
without.
But there's a couple, you know, a lot of the dialogue is the same. And so me being someone who pretty much knew all the dialogue. You know, I found that's probably what the biggest problem I had with the movie is because I knew that much about it and I knew what was coming and what to expect. I knew how they said it in the cartoon. They definitely don't say it like how they did it.
Which is why, to me, I think going into it, people have expectations because everybody who loves it our age would know the dialogue. So like everything, every line they would say, I'd expect this pitch at this word, this pitch at this word. And if they don't say it that way, it's almost like, is it that nice? Did I like them saying it like that? But I still loved it. It had great scenes, great parts, but then some of it, mainly Beyonce and her song. Kind of spoils it for me. But yeah, I think it's that. I think because we know it line for line, we expected it to be the same because almost everything else was the same. But then they don't say it the same every time. So then it's like,
guys, that's a record. Like, she was talking for like a minute. Wow.
Shut up.
The only real thing that you have to gauge on is the voice performances, and I would say some of them were good, some of them weren't great. No, none of them were bad, but a lot of them felt like they were reading from the script. It didn't feel like how it felt when you watch, even if you watch it now, if you watch the cartoon now, it don't feel like how the emotions came across in the cartoon for a lot of the stuff. And I've heard a lot of people online say that it was because they looked so photoreal. So you know, in the cartoon their eyes got big and they, you know, they cried and they got sad faces and stuff like that. They definitely don't do that in this one because real lions don't do that. You know, lions don't make up their face like that, or any other animals, they don't make those kind of emotive faces. And so that wasn't it for me. It literally was like they gave the actors the script and the actors read it a lot of times in the movie. And that kind of took me out of it. More so because I knew how it should have sounded. Especially James Earl Jones.
And he was the only repeat one. So that hurt. I expected his lines to be like exactly the same.
That one hurt so much. James Earl Jones, like, God bless his soul.
Some of it wasn't bad.
As old as he is, you can hear the age in his voice. And you could, some of them were good, some of them, he was literally just reading off the script.
I think the worst one was the one he had said, the confrontation between him and Simba after the elephant graveyard thing. I think that was the worst one.
I mean, we're not giving away any spoilers here, guys.
No, everybody knows the cartoon.
30 years old. So, you know, that part after he saves them from the elephant graveyard and he starts out cussing him off and then, you know, they end up having their father-son bonding moment. You don't feel like Simba was really intimidated by him in that moment. Like Simba, in the cartoon, he was almost in tears talking to Mufasa. And you just didn't get that from Simba. Simba was like, yeah, dad, I'll try to be like you, bro. You know, that's kind of how it came off. It's like, that's how the Simba played it. The movie was still good. I'll still see it 5 times, not
Timon
in the theaters.
Timon and Pumbaa were really good.
Yeah. They were the best part of the movie.
They were the best.
Timon was a little too much. Timon was a little too much at point. But Seth Rogen.
I love them.
It's, go figure, Seth Rogen nailed the stoner pig character.
Yeah.
That was perfect. But Timon had his moments where it was a little too much.
It was okay for me.
But yeah,
they made those characters their own, but still funny and still like this what
we want. Yeah, the grown up characters for the most part I was pretty good with Beyonce. You just can't not hear Beyonce.
Yeah.
She didn't do terribly, but it was like it's literally Beyonce to a lion
really
figure.
I really didn't like Can You Feel the Love Tonight. I didn't.
It was too much Beyonce in it.
Yeah, she Beyonce'd it from the first verse.
Yeah, from literally her first line.
Line, exactly. I was like,
she was doing a hoo, that's exactly how she was.
The extra. You don't have the extra.
But again, that is expectation too, because when we listen to the Broadway album, the original songs for the play are amazing on that Broadway album, but when you listen to the 94, the songs that they redid for the play, it's not the original, and it's the same thing with the songs in here tonight. I'm sure the kids that are seeing it first will like it, will love it, love those songs, because they don't have anything to go off of, but we do, and that was a problem. It's definitely the best Disney redo that they've done, for me at least. I honestly don't think they'll ever get it better than that.
We'll see. They have more. But I think because this was like your ultimate movie, I thought.
Probably should have done that on camera. Cinderella was okay. Beauty and the Beast was okay.
Oh, I forgot about Cinderella. I was never read that somewhere. Cinderella. I
watched them. I don't remember anything. Watched all of them. I don't remember them. But yeah, they're gonna do what's next? Mulan and then
Mulan is gonna be
Mulan don't look nothing like the cartoon. So yeah. I don't think there's any expectation
singing,
that you can
no,
do with that.
No.
But
that's like a crouching tiger hidden dragon kind of vibe.
But yeah, anyway. I don't know, maybe we could do this because most of what Gillian and I do is sit down and watch TV shows and movies because, you know, we're boring and we're having life.
Favorite pastime.
So maybe we can make a thing of this. Let me know what you think below. Like, subscribe. We'll be back next time.